The love of women is the most beautiful of all that mortals experience. Thou losest thy nights in cherishing youths who are ungrateful to us. Beside their narrow planks, consider our luxuriant hips, broad hollow couches for lovers. Say above all, what human lips, except hers who wish it, can elaborate the pleasure? Why have I become lesbian, thou askest? But what player of a flute is not a little? I am poor, I have no bed. I lie with her who wishes me, and I thank her with what I have. While yet small, we dance naked. Those dances, thou knowest them. The 12 desires of Aphrodite. We regard each other. We compare our nudities and we find them so pretty. During the long night, we inflame ourselves for pleasure of spectators, but our ardor is not feigned, and we feel it so much that sometimes, behind the doors, one of us may animate her companion who consents. How then can we love a man who is rough with us? He seizes us as girls and leaves us before the delight. Woman, thou knowest what I mean. Thou attachest to thy light hands the resounding crotales, my dear Nescadica, and almost naked from thy robe, thou extendest thy nervous limbs. How pretty thou art, thine arms in the air, thy loins arched, and thy breasts reddened. Thou commencest, thy feet, one before the other, pose, hesitate, and glide softly. Thy body bends like a scarf. Thy caresses thy shivering skin, and voluptuousness inundates thy long, swooning eyes. Suddenly thou strikest the crotales. Arch thyself erect upon thy feet. Shake thy loins. Advance thy legs and let thy hands, filled with noise, call all the desires in a band about thy turning body. We applaud with great cries as smiling over thy shoulder, thou agitatest with a shiver thy convulsed muscular croup, or whether thou undulate, almost extended, to the rhythm of thy memory. Anthus, dancing girl of Lydia, has 7 veils upon her. She unrolls the yellow veil. Her black hair spreads out. The rosy veil slips from her mouth. The white veil falls, revealing her naked arms. She releases her little breast from the red veil that unties itself. She lets fall the green veil from her double-rounded croup. She draws the blue veil from her shoulders, but she presses upon her puberty the last transparent veil. The young men supplicate her. She tosses her head backwards. Only at the sound of a flute, she tears it a little. Then suddenly, with the gestures of a dance, she culls the flowers of her body, singing. Behold my roses, I give them to you. Behold my violets. Will you have them? Behold my fair curled parsley. Within the enclosure thrice mysterious, where the men may never enter, we have made a festival for thee, Aphrodite of the night, mother of the world, fountain of the life of the gods. I will reveal something, but not more than is permitted. About a phallus crown, 100 women rocked, shrieking. The initiates wore the habits of men, The others, the divided tunics. Smoke of perfumes, the fumes of torches waver between us like clouds. I wept burning tears. All at the feet of the gerbia, we cast ourselves upon our backs. At last, when the religious act was consummated, and when, in the unique triangle, had been plunged the crimson phallus, the mystery commenced. But I will tell no more. Upon a white terrace in the night, they abandon us, swooning among the roses. A warm perspiration slipped away like tears from our armpits over our breasts. Overwhelming voluptuousness purpled our thrown back heads. Four captive doves, bathed in four perfumes, fluttered above us in the silence. From their wings, drops of perfume fell upon the naked women. I rested my cheek upon the belly of a young girl who enveloped herself in the cool of my moist hair. The perfume of her saffron skin intoxicated my open mouth. She closed her thighs about my neck. I slept, but an exhausting dream awakened me. A bird of nocturnal desire sang, distracting me from afar. I coughed with a little shiver. Little by little, a languishing arm like a flower raised itself in the air toward the moon. Nesedika, thou art there. For in the secret of thy body, it is thou, Nesedika, beloved, who hidest the cave of the nymphs in which old Homer spoke, the place where the naiads weave their purple linens, the place where glide, drop by drop, the inexhaustible springs, and where the gate of the north lets men descend, and the gate of the south lets immortals enter. Breathless, I take her hand and apply it forcibly to the moist skin of my left breast. And I turn my head here and there, and I move my lips without speaking. My excited heart, abrupt and hard, beats and beats in my breast as an imprisoned satyr would knock. Imprisoned in a leathern bottle. She says to me, thy heart makes thee ill. Oh, Nesedika, I respond. The heart of a woman is not there. That is only a poor bird, a dove which stirs its feeble wings. The heart of a woman is more terrible. Like a little myrtle berry, it burns with a red flame and under an abundant foam. It is there that I feel myself bitten by voracious Aphrodite.